Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSC and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we'll take one more numerical, question number 8 on refraction of light. Students, let's start the question number 8. It is a very interesting question. It says that there is a prism. It says that the A is the angle of the prism and a ray strikes the surface at an angle greater, double the angle of the prism. So I is given as 2A and it goes and it undergoes refraction and finds the other face. The second surface is silvered. So it's given in the question that the surface is silvered. It behaves like a mirror. So this, from this side, the ray cannot come out. So it will undergo reflection. So basic purpose of silvering is for reflection of the light at this face. So this ray, incident ray, this is the normal, hits the surface an angle of incidence of 2a, twice the angle of the prism. It will undergo refraction and finds this surface, the mirror, such a way that it is given the question that after reflection it comes back, it follows the same path. It follows the same path. Suppose that this is the, this is how the ray is refracted in the, in this medium, and it follows the same path. If it follows the same path, the angle here should be 90 degree. Only when the ray is sent back, normally it will follow the same path. So this angle is 90 degree. So it is sent back and it follows the same path. It says that it follows the same path. Then in this case, you are asked to find the refractive index of the material of this prism. This is the question. So let me write the question for you. The angle of the prism is A. A. The angle of incidence at one face is twice the angle of prism. The second surface and the ray strikes the second surface strike the silvered surface in such a way that after reflection it follows the same path. We are supposed to find the refractive index of the prism. So this is the solution. As we can see from here, this angle is double the angle of the prism. This strikes the surface and returns back in the same direction. So this angle has to be 90 degree. This is 90, this is A. So this angle has to be 90 minus A. This angle is 2A. Now what is the angle of refraction? Because to find the mu you have to use Snell's law. Then what is this angle? This angle is called angle of refraction, and that angle of refraction can be found by 90 minus of this value, because this angle is 90 minus A. So this angle R would be 90 minus A. This comes out to be 90 minus 90 plus A. This goes, so A is the angle. So this angle of refraction is same as the angle of the prism. The angle of incidence is double. Now we can apply Snell's law at the point of incidence. Applying Snell's law, at the points of incidence on first surface, mu comes out to be sin I upon sin r. So sin I upon sin r, therefore if I put the value mu equals to sin of I, I is given in the question as twice the angle of the prism. R we got now as A. So this becomes sin of 2A by sin of A. If I solve this, sin 2 theta is 2 sin of A cos of A divided by sin of A. If I cancel this, then we are left with 2 cos of A. So the refractive index of the material of the prism is twice the cos of A. For example, if I say that the angle of the prism is suppose 30 degree and angle of incidence is 60 degree, then what is the refractive index of the prism? So what is given here is A, what is given here is I. So if angle of incidence is greater, double the angle of the prism, in that case the refractive index can be found directly with the help of this formula. So this is just one formula under this condition, 2 of cos A. So if this is the question asked, then you can write 2 cos A, that is 2 cos of A is 30, 2 cos 30 is 2, cos 30 is root 3 divided by 2. So 2 to cancel, so this is root 3. So therefore, in this situation, the refractive index will be root of 3, which is 1.73. So this is how you apply the formula. Okay, thank you.